Hi everybody, welcome to this video. This is Esther here. So in this video I'm showing you this drawing right here, which you all can see. This is called as mandala drawing or mandala art. So I just decided to do this art as, you know, sort of hobby or you know, an activity during my free time, and it turned out to be pretty good. And this is like I think my first or second attempt in this, and I feel it has like come out really good, and I really enjoy doing this, and it is a really time engaging hobby to do, and overall when you look at it from like a distance and even at this angle, it looks really beautiful, like a real dress. So I really enjoy doing this, and I would encourage all of you to do this. So I hope you like this drawing, and I did this using basically these four, you know, things plus a pencil, you can say. Using these four, five things, I have like done this. So basically, first I have like traced out the basic outline and everything using this pencil. Like you see this outer boundary here, the skirt, and then this top and this outer boundary, all using this pencil I've done. So I would also encourage all of you to, you know, like draw the boundary with the pencil, because if you're new to some particular, you know, art or some drawing, first basically you should try doing it with a pencil, because if you have any mistake you can erase it and redraw it. But if you do it with a pen, there you go, you have a waste of paper and ink and so much of loss as well. So you can start with a pencil, and that's a very good idea, truly love it. So next, what I did was I just, you know, took a deeper outline by using this marker. Right, so the name of this is, I think you can see it here, this is basically Luxa, you can see it's a CD DVD marker. So if you have any other, you know, pen or some marker or gel pen similar to this one, which gives you like this boundary which you can see, okay, this boundary which you can see, if you have anything like that, you can use it other than this CD DVD. So if you use this marker, then you could expect like marks like this at the back. I'll just show you the marks that you could get. As you can see here, tada, you would get these marks at the back, and, you know, sort of like your dots here as well. So I had no other alternative but to just choose this marker to do and give this thickness and boldness only using a marker. But if you have any other option, please be glad to go ahead with that. So then, as you can see, if I just showed in the light, you can find some glittery lines and glittery patches, like these lines, and, you know, these circles as well, and these glitter dots as well. So let me tell you what I used here. Yes, as you already guessed, this is done using a glitter pen. So I've just done this with a glitter pen. I just felt it would, you know, give a little more better look. If you look at it at a distance and, you know, in the light, if you just see, you would find that it's glittery and it really looks nice for appearance matters as well. Then many things I did using a black pen. You could use a black pen, which is a ball pen, or a gel pen you could use. So I've done like some lines like these, and, you know, you see this line here, let me just point that out for you. You see this line here, yeah, all these are done. And if you see these designs here, this is also done using that ball pen. So I really loved using this ball pen. It was very comfortable for usage, and it gave very good design. So if you need to do like some very thin designs, you could use a ball pen or a gel pen, you know, according to your colors or whatever you like. So then for some things, I used a sketch pen here. So as you can see here, down here, okay, I'll just try showing it in the light. Okay, I'll help you to recognize it. So basically, these borders here, which you can see, like, not borders, this triangular design, which is having like the thick triangular design. I'm talking about those things. I've done that using the sketch pen. So you could also use sketch pen. If you have a very good black sketch pen, a nice working sketch pen, you could use that instead of a marker as well. But I was running out of ink, so I decided to do these dots and all of that using this marker. And another advantage of this CD-DVD marker is that, you know, when you just place a dot on the page, it would like, the ink would like spread, you know, to form a dot. So you just need to like place it. I'll just do it and show it to you right now. Yeah, so if you just like place it here, tada, see, I just like placed it. I'm not even like moving it. I'm just placing it there. So you get those dots really quickly and easily. So I really found that interesting. So I think these are the only things I used in this mandala drawing, this girl. I feel that overall it's an outstanding output, and for the second try I would say it has come out like too good, and I really enjoy doing this. This is a very I won't say seducing, but it is a very engaging artwork, and I would encourage all of you, those who are watching this video, to, you know, try out this mandala art. I'm telling you, it's 100% good. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will get back in the next video with some more new things to engage you and bring you into this video, like a real interaction sort of. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. Bye bye for now.